Guys, my name is Vivek, and in this video tutorial, we are going to talk about debugger in Informatica. Guys, I have a quick request. If you have not subscribed to my channel already, please go ahead and do it now so that you get a notification as soon as I upload a new video. One thing I've noticed is that a lot of developers are proficient when it comes to creating mappings, workflows, or session, but they actually don't use this beautiful functionality provided by Informatica, using which you can see how the data is flowing in your mapping between your transformation and whether you will actually achieve the desired result in your final target tables or files. I make it a point to use Informatica Debugger extensively during my unit testing, and if I ever face any production issues, Informatica Debugger is the first thing I resort to. Guys, there is another important thing I want to mention right now. When you are using Informatica Debugger, you actually don't want to use the entire source data set. You want to use only a part of the source data, and you want that data to cover as many scenarios as possible. The objective of using Informatica Debugger is to actually see how your mapping or how your session or how your workflow will actually act in different scenarios. A lot of people actually make this mistake. They run their debugger with the entire source data, and then that is too overwhelming for them. They are not able to capture the scenarios. So it's actually of vital importance that you choose a subset of the data that can cover majority of the scenarios, or you actually create your test data in a way that it covers all the scenario that you want to test as a part of your unit testing or as a part of debugging the production issue. If you are using a flat file as a source or multiple flat files as source, I would recommend using a subset of those flat files which can cover majority of the scenarios. And if you're using a single table or multiple tables, you should actually override your source qualifier query so that it only picks a subset of the data. Now here I have created a mapping to actually demonstrate dynamic lookup. So I receive employee data from my source system on a daily basis, and there is a possibility that I may have more than one record for a single employee on a particular file. So for example, Vivek is an employee of the organization ABC, and this data is being sent to the warehouse of ABC, but they made multiple changes for Vivek, like they updated location and they updated his phone number in multiple batches, and now this particular source file, the flat file, it has multiple rows. So if I try to implement this with static lookup, I'm going to get primary constraint violation in my warehouse. So I have actually implemented dynamic lookup to tackle this situation, and we will see in a moment how the debugger works. So in order to run the debugger, you need to go to mappings, then go to debugger, and then go to start debugger. Then you will see this screen. You just have to click next. This is a vital screen. You have to specify the integration service using which you are going to run your mapping. So I have a single integration service_demo. I'm going to use that. There is a possibility that in your project, you may be using multiple integration services for a single folder. So you want to choose the one using which you want to run your code in production as well. So you have multiple options here. Either you can go ahead and create a debug session instance. If I go ahead and do this, I will have to specify certain options like the connection of my source, the location where I'm going to write my file, and that kind of stuff. I have already created a session instance, and that is the one that I'm going to use here. So on this screen, the two vital things that you need to select is the integration service using which you're going to run your session in production, and whether you're going to opt for an existing session instance or you want to create a debug session instance. I usually recommend that once you have created your mapping, you go ahead and you create your session and workflow as well, and then run the debugger on that existing instance. Otherwise, you will have to duplicate your effort. You create a debug session instance, you supply the variables for your source connection, target connections, lookups, and then again, you have to do the same for your final session as well. So I usually create this session well in advance, and I use that particular session for my debugging purposes. Now there is a possibility that I may have multiple sessions for a single mapping. I will have to choose one of those sessions. Here I only have one session corresponding to this mapping, so I'm going to select that. And finally, it's going to ask me, as a part of this debugger run, are you going to load this data into your final table, or are you going to discard it? Guys, I will highly recommend discarding the data, since you are either trying to do a unit test or you are trying to debug some issues. That means there is a fair chance that your end data is not going to be perfect. As I've mentioned that we have created certain test data to test as many scenarios as possible. So by default, you're going to leave this option checked that you're going to discard the target data. Now let's go ahead and run our debugger and see how the data is flowing. So I'm going to pull these bars. This is my target instance where I'm going to see the final values that are going to enter this particular table. And this is what will show me the data flow, how the data is flowing between transformation. So first I'm going to run it again. I'm going to press next instance. I can also use F10. So it's showing me the first row where the ID is 4, the name is Rio, the salary is 700, and it's saying that the row type is insert. That means this particular data will be forwarded to the next transformation. I'm going to press F10. It reaches my expression transformation where I'm not doing anything. The same data persisted. It's going to be passed to the next transformation. Now here I'm doing a dynamic lookup, and the value that was returned was 1. Now the value 1 in new lookup row indicates that this row is going to get inserted. That means this ID was not present in my database, so it's going to get inserted. I'm going to press F10. It went to the update strategy transformation where I've specified the condition. Let's just quickly check that. So I have specified that if the value is 1, do an insert, otherwise do an update. So since Rio was not present in my database, it's going to do an insert, which was expected, and I got the same data in my target instance. So if I run it as a part of session and this value enters my transformations, it's going to get inserted in the final table. Now if you see, the same value has come again. The salary has changed. Earlier the salary of Rio was 700, now it's 900. Now let's see how dynamic lookup is going to function. So the same value was passed to the expression transformation. When I enter the lookup transformation, it knows that this value already exists in the database as a part of my last row insert. It was inserted in the database. So instead of specifying the value 1, it came as 0, and it understood that it has to do an update instead of an insert. So when I go ahead and pass this value to the update strategy using F10, it will know that this particular row type is update instead of insert. So on the final target table, it's going to go as an update instead of an insert. And guys, coming back to the first point where I mentioned that you want to have limited test data that can cover as many scenarios as possible. For example, if I used a huge file here with majority of the unique values, and the first value Rio was repeated at the 1000th row, I would have to traverse 1000 row in order to verify whether my code is running correctly or not. So it's vital that you keep your source data as minimal as possible. At the same time, you need to make sure that your source data actually covers all the scenarios that you want to test as a part of this debugger run. So I made sure that if it's a new row, the data is getting inserted. If it's an old row, the data will be updated. Now I'll go ahead and run it for the rest of the rows. So now I have Roger. Roger is again a new employee. So I got 1 for him. The data was inserted. Now I have Vivek. Vivek already exists in the database. So this row type will be update instead of insert. And if I see in my target, it will be an update. So guys, though I only had 4 rows in my source, it actually tested 3 scenarios for me. The first scenario was with Rio. Whenever a new record comes, it should go ahead and get inserted. Then I tried to insert Rio as a part of the same file to test that my dynamic lookup is working correctly. It was working correctly. That's why instead of inserting it, it went ahead and updated that particular row. Then I went ahead and inserted an isolated row for Roger. That was again inserted. And finally, I had an employee Vivek who was already existing in the database. I got a new row for him. Instead of inserting that particular row, it was updated by my mapping. That means my usual or normal update is also working correctly. So if I press F10 right now, it's going to shut down my debugger. And if I connect to my workflow monitor, it will show me that I was doing a debug run for this particular session. So guys, just to quickly recap what we discussed today, debugger is a beautiful functionality provided by Informatica using which you can see the data flow between your transformation. You should use it extensively when you are doing unit testing or in case if you have any UAT or prod issues. Debugger should be the first thing that you should rely to actually replicate that scenario and fix it. Another important mistake which a lot of developers make is they don't set their test data correctly from source. You want to restrict your test data to a limited volume, at the same time ensuring that your test data covers as many scenarios as possible. If you are working with flat files, use a subset of the data. If you are using database tables, make sure that you override your session queries and add an additional where clause so that you get only a subset of the entire source data. We saw that we only took 4 rows and we covered majority of the scenarios using this. You need to make sure that you replicate your data in a similar manner. Thanks a lot guys for watching this video, and if you have any questions regarding Informatica Debugger, please drop in a comment and I'll try to answer them as soon as possible.